While we are self-quarantining ourselves to evade coronavirus, this new lifestyle has completely messed our schedule up. The brewing stress and anxiety is leading to more of snacking and more of Netflix and chill and less of activity. Am I right or am I right? Hello beautiful people, welcome or welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know me, hi, my name is Prarthana Banerjee and I'll be really glad if you take a moment and consider subscribing to my channel. And today I'm going to talk about that how you can speed up your weight loss process and stop yourself from gaining more weight during this lockdown / quarantine period. Tip number one. Go grocery shopping and go to pick your snacks up after you have had your meal. Guess why? Because when you're hungry, you tend to go ahead and pick your favorite snacking items such as processed food, the chicken salami, the chicken nuggets, those chips and crackers and chocolates. That's a bad idea. But once you are full and you know that once you go and enter the grocery store, you'll have your list ready, you'll pick the things that you really need, and you can leave those snacks behind. So take this tip and start practicing it. Tip number two is keeping those chips and chocolates out of your sight. Now, it is a possibility that you do already have some snacks at your home, and this just happens. This is the human psychology that the moment you see them, your mind will trigger you to go ahead and start snacking on them. Trust me, that happens with me too. So just hide them somewhere so that once a week or once in 10 days when you are having your cheat meal, you can go ahead and indulge in some. But keep the healthy snacks in sight and make sure that you hide them so that even if you don't want to, and even after you have promised yourself that you will not go ahead and snack, indulge in those chips and chocolates, wow. So when you have promised yourself that you will not indulge in any kind of junk food so that you can stick to your promise. That was a lot of so that, but yeah, that's the tip number two. Tip number three is scheduling your meals. I understand when you are at home, like, it's very obvious that having just three meals a day might lead to boredom in between, and that can lead do more snacking. So schedule your meals, make it 5 times a day, but take care of your portion. Do not have heavy meals each and every time. Your 5 meals can consist of a breakfast, lunch and dinner as your 3 main meals, and in between you can incorporate some snacks. Like supposedly if you have breakfast at 9, at 11 as snacks you can have a bowl full of fresh fruits. I love it. I love a bowl full of mixed fresh fruits. They are amazing. They really keep you full. And then supposedly at 1 or 2 you're having your lunch, then you can go ahead and have your snacks again, evening snacks that is, at around 5 or 6. For that you can have dry fruits, you can have fox nuts. They are really really good. You can go ahead and Google some fox nut recipes. You can roast them up. They are crunchy. They exactly feel like chips and crackers, but they are such a healthy option. And then you can go ahead and have your dinner at 7:30 or 8. I will really recommend you to have an early dinner. So you can schedule your meals and that will help you keep your calorie intake in control. After scheduling your meals comes planning your meals. Just scheduling is not enough. The moment you are entering your kitchen, if you have not planned your meal, and if you have not, in fact, I would recommend that you have your meals ready. Prepare your meals, break them into portions, and then put them in the freezer, heat them up, and you can have them. But also, if you prefer having freshly cooked food, like I personally do too, in that case, the moment you enter your kitchen, if you do not have your meals planned, in that case, you tend to go ahead and prepare something that is ready to make, such as noodles, pasta, sandwich, cheese grilled sandwiches. They are really really unhealthy, so make sure that you plan your meal day prior to the next, to the day you are going to go ahead and have them. Like if I am going to plan my meal today, I'll be planning that what I'll be having for my breakfast, lunch, dinner and snacks tomorrow and so on. So what planning your meals does is that you will know how much calories, what and how are you going to intake, and you can take care of the portions, you can take care of the quantity, you can take care of the ingredients, the stuff altogether, and hence you will also make sure that you are not ending up intaking the calorie that you do not intend to intake. The next step is working out. Trust me, if you guys are waiting for the gyms to open, that's an excuse. If you used to go to gym, if you are planning to go to gym, keep on doing it. Start today. Start working out. I understand you may not be able to motivate yourself to work out each and every day. And trust me, that's okay. It's not even that healthy to work out each and every day. Work out, if possible, work out 5 times a week. If you cannot do that, at least work out 2 times a week. At least. Come on, you can do that. You can give yourself those 10 to 15 minutes. Go and do HIIT workout, cardio workout, be active. It will really, really get your heart pumping. And that is not only good for your weight loss journey, but it is really, really good for your overall health. So make sure that you are not stopping to work out. And if you have stopped, just start right away. The last tip that I have for you guys is staying active in general. I know when you tend to stay at home, when you are staying at home all day, since days, and you do not know when is the next time you will be going out, you tend to sit and sleep and relax a lot. Even if you are working from home, you tend to take your laptop, lie down or sit on the sofa and then work. And trust me, that is going to give you a lot of belly fat, and I'm sure you do not want that if you want to fit into your old clothes after the quarantine period is over. So make sure that you're active. Every half an hour, get up, take a walk around your house, or go and fetch your water bottle. Keep yourself hydrated. Make sure you're active in general. Play with your pets. If you do not have pets, you can play with your siblings. If you stay alone, or if you do not have anybody to play with, just walk around the house. Clean your room, clean your shelves, clean your wardrobe, stay active. It really keeps you going, and also it will actually keep your energy and mood uplifted too. It is a very good habit, so make sure that you are not turning yourself into a couch potato. Stay active during this quarantine. This is a very, very, very little step. It is not that difficult, but it is going to make a huge difference in your lifestyle, and it will definitely help you lose some more weight and shed a few more pounds during this quarantine. That is it for the video, you guys. I really hope you found this video informative. I really don't want you guys to, you know, sit back, turn yourself into a couch potato, and then regret after you start going out because you're either not fitting in your clothes or you just have low self-esteem because of gaining all those pounds. If you're happy gaining them, go ahead and do that. But if you want to lose weight during this quarantine period, make sure that you implement the tips that I have given you in your daily life. They will bring a major difference, and they will, you will get to see the change, I'm sure. And I love you guys so much. I really care for you. Please take care of yourself and your family members. And I'll see you very, very, very soon once again in my next video. Also, subscribe to my channel. Bye, guys.